There she goes.
Bev.
Thank you, Bev.
Don't say I never gave you anything.
Don't say I never gave you anything. Say goodbye. What's the matter, babe?
Marry me.
What?
Leave your baby right here, right now. Before I go in there, I want you to get married to
Deacon,
me.
Deacon, I see what you're doing.
Come on, we can find a chaplain that can come up here in just a second.
Babe,
we can do this, or
no,
I want to do it.
I need you to listen to me right now. I've been watching you these last couple days, and I know you've got it in your head somewhere that you're not going to get through this. The way you've been with Beverly, the way you're pulling people in close to you, but you are.
I'm having these dreams, so you got to listen to me. Real as day, I dreamt it, all right? I'm on the table, I'm in the ground,
hey,
I'm...
You know what? I've got dreams, too. About you and me getting old together. And we got these girls, and I dream about us raising them up. And I dream about the beautiful wedding we'll have, full of love. So no, babe, I'm not gonna marry you in some cold hospital room. But I will tell you this. Irene and James take you, Deacon Claymore, to be my husband. Your turn.
I, Deacon Claymore, take you, Anna James. Be my wife.
To have and to hold.
Yeah, have and to hold.
For richer or poorer.
For richer and for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
Yeah.
Now don't you dare go and leave me a widow.